Now, so in the past lectures, we understand how this function is working because we have introduced this function in our last lecture, and we understand that the function is a block of code and executed when someone is invoked. And we also understand this as see all the JavaScript programs works within a script hypertext markup within markup of the script. And we have a function which defined a variable and which parameterized the thing, and then we have a return type which give us the result. And for pass and for parameter for these are the variable which are characterized, and these are for the giving the value for the calculation. We need to call a space within a HTML document, and we need to call a space to HTML document where that result will be shown. Okay, and that's for that we use document.get element by ID demo dot inner HTML. It is like my that's why it just gives us a space. It just gives us a space, and this space is given by that. And after calculation of this 4x3, we get a result 12, and this on that space we print this 12. So this is what our function is all about, and it is a designed for a particular task and invokes when it is called. Now, what is the syntax of that JavaScript function? Because we know that so in past in our C language, the syntax is a very important characteristic for applying the function concept. Okay. Now here we just define a function as a keyword. This function from which a function will be initialized is a keyword, and following by the name. Following by a name, it is also known as a function name. Like they hear it as my function, and then a parenthesis, then a parenthesis, and then we pass a parameter. Here we pass a parameter p1 and p2. Okay, this is example of the statement. This is a function keyword, and this is a function name, and this we pass the parameter p1 and p2. Now let's move. The code of to be executed by the function is placed inside the curly braces. Function definition, you can say that this is the function definition by parenthesis, but within a curly bracket we define a function, and here we define a function. A return type will be the multiplication of 2. That's it. Return type will be multiplication of the 2. Function parameters are listed inside the parenthesis in the function definition. Function arguments are the values received by the function when it is invoked. Inside the function, the arguments, the parameters behave as a local variables. Very important concept. Inside the function, the arguments behaves as a local variables. Function is much the same as the procedure in the or a subroutine in the other programming languages. This is like this. Now let's go. Function invocation. The code inside the function will execute when something invokes call the function. When an event occurs, when a user clicks a button, when it invoke called from a, how we invoke a function when event occurs, when a user clicks a button, when it is invoked, when it is called for a JavaScript code, automatically it is self invoked. It's all about how we define the concept of the function within a script code, within a script element, and the definition within the curly braces. Now what is the return statement in the function definition? The function return, when a function reaches the return statement, the function will stop executing. If the function was involved from a statement, now JavaScript will return. Whenever this return will strike, the function will stop executing. This is the main criteria we need to understand. The function will stop executing the thing. Now, function often compute a return value. The return value is returned back to the call. And where will return value will they go?
return valuing back to the caller, you know, it's a very much a defined thing. When you define a thing, it's very much a definition actually.
Okay. When we call a function and how it is a return of value. Let's move. Why function? You can reuse code, define the code once and use it many times. Why we need a function? The most important property is we can reuse that code. Okay. We can define a code once and use it many a times. Okay. Now, you can use the same code many times. You can use the same code many times with different arguments to produce different results. Now, here, if we have P1 and P2 and we got a 4 and 3, let's make it 2, 2, 3, 4, and then run this statement. We are getting this value 702. That's what a reusability concept is all about. That's what a reusability concept is all about. We just, here we are doing this. We are creating a function to from Celsius to Fahrenheit, and return will be 5 by 9 cross Fahrenheit minus 32. And how it is going well done? We have discussed this thing. How document, HTML DML will first make a tree of document, then we, you know, we get an element by ID, and that demo will be initialized as a variable. And then in another HTML will give a space to the Celsius calculation of 77. You know, here the functions within a function of the Celsius, we have defined the value 77. Let's make it 177. What will the result? With the 77, it was 25. With the 127, it's 80.555. You know, signal at last, it is a 6 actually, because the, you know, definition of the numbers and how we proceed the thing. And we are reusing this for function variation. That's why function is a very important tool. Now, let's have a little bit more research documentation on the function. What is function? Function used as variable value. What is function? Function used as a variable value. Function used as variable values. Very important concept. Function can be used at the same way as you use variables in all types of formulas, assignments, and calculations. When you upgrade yourself to the Java, in Java, function is basically worked as a method, and we tried. We use several times this, you know, this method function used as a several times as a variable values in mainly in the networking. We just define something within a URL method, and then that will initiate an object, and then we again define an object, and it just works well. So something is like this. Now let's move. How this we store. How instead of using a variable to store the return value of a function, how we can do something different? It is a different way to store the return value of a function. How it is going to be done? See this program. See, we just make a demo. We need that. We need to initialize that. We need to initialize this to make a space out here. Okay. And here is the temperature. Is like a string. It will be permanent. It will print itself as a string. It is printed as itself as a string. Then it will follow this notation. 2 Celsius 77. Okay. 2 Celsius underscore 77. And see, this 2, we are using function as a variable. This is the function name, 2 Celsius, and using it as a variable 2 Celsius. Okay, and we just pass 77 within it, and after calculation of the 5 by 9 and Fahrenheit minus 32, we are getting this result, and we just concatenate this result with the Celsius. Okay, make it 717. What will be the result? Result will change itself. And due to this property of inner HTML, and the result is such a, you know, stressed. Results has been stressed, but still it has adjusted itself, because JavaScript can change the structure of HTML, because it has an important attribute to change the aspect of it. Let's move. So we understand we can use Java the Java function name. We can use this Java function name as a variable as well. And see, we just initiated like this. We use this function name and pass it like this finally. Local variables. Variables declared within a JavaScript function become a local to the function. What will happen? Local variables declared within a JavaScript function become local to the function. What will this local variable will do? Local variables can only be accessed from within the function. What will happen? See, it will happen like this. Local variable can only be accessed from within the function. This is a very important concept. We need to understand this. We can define local variable within a JavaScript function. Meaning that when we defining a body for a function under the semicolon, this is the variable we can define within a function. We had defined a variable car name within a my function. Okay, within a my function, we defined a variable. That's what it is defined. We can define a local variable within a function. That's all. See, we defined a by function. We just see this here. We have an HTML. We start a body. In body, we define a header. We define a paragraph. And we define a demo one, demo two. And this is what my function is. In the function, my function, we define a variable. And the variable name is Volvo. And then again, we initiate this. And we need to get a type of car name. See, type of is a keyword which gives a result. What type of if we define the car name, what will be its data type? And then we'll be right down here, and then car name will be written. See, this is a very interesting program. We just define a car name as a Volvo, okay, and here we are getting a data type of this Volvo, and we understand that when there is a double inverted comma in Volvo, it is like a string. So the calculation will show the parameter data type of this Volvo here and the car name definition of the variable here, and in the following. So when we run this program, the first function is giving this variable name is string and its name as a Volvo. So finally, this function has been executed as string Volvo. Now, see here, we just call a second demo and need to get a type of car name. Okay, but it is showing undefined. Why it is showing undefined? Because it works fine out here. It works fine out here. Why it is showing undefined here? Have this question within your mind. Because this is a local variable and it will only it defined within this curly braces. And if we do one job, just put this curly braces here, okay, then run the program, then we will get the string. But initially, in the program we defined the curly braces here. So function is executing this much of a statement only. It is not executing this much of a statement. Okay, that's why we got in this example we'll get unknown. But if we increase the body of function, we will get string. That's what here it is defining itself. Local variables are only recognized inside a function. Okay. Variables within the same name can be used in a different function. Variables with the same name can be used as a different function. Now, local variables are created when a function starts. What will happen? The local variables are created when a function starts and deleted when a function is completed. Okay. Once a local variable is used, it was created and deleted when function will be used. When function will be used, it will be deleted. Now, here see. we have a my function method. We have a my function, my function function, and we have an alert. And we have just crossed the, we have this much. Alert, hello world, hello world. And they are asking, what will the result? Actually, see, here the parenthesis has been closed. Parenthesis will be closed. So we need to call a my function for really an, understanding this job. Okay. So let's, it's all about function now. We have 6.5 minutes. So let's have an introduction of object as well. It is two important topics within your unit 4. We have touched this. I will not say cover because whatever programming it is, it's just a starting. Any programming dimension is just a starting. Its application area is such a vast. We can't say we covered function. We just introduced function to your life, from which you can be benefited immense as per need. As per the need, we will be benefited. In our course structure, we have a concept and see JavaScript objects and function in as a topic. And above that, we have JavaScript pop-up boxes, JavaScript events, JavaScript arrays, working with arrays. So, though JavaScript event is not something a very different thing. Whatever working we are using now, after objects we have events. So this concept will be taken care after this concept, after object concept. First of all, understand what is object. Then we will go for the events. Then we will go for the randomers, you know, array. We will take care of the string numbers as well, and we will take care of the, you know, array methods, short and array iterations. Okay. So let's focus on the object. We have 4.5 minutes, and just we will go for the interesting introduction of real world object within JavaScript. Okay, real life objects, properties and methods. In real life, a car is an object. A car has properties like weight and color and methods like start and stop. Okay, see, object is car. Car dot name is fear. Car dot model is 5 kg. Car dot weight is 850 kg. Car dot color is white. And now it is denoting itself. Car dot start, car dot drive, car dot brake, car dot stop. All the class have the same, or the car has the same properties, but the property values differ from car to car. Actually, maybe my have a Maruti model and has 800, car weight maybe, you know, 1250 kg, maybe car color will be black or red. Okay, so this is start, this is drive, this is brake, this is stop, you know. So methods will be same. A property can be changed. The method can be, you know, can also be like, you know, here it is a method like start, stop, drive, brake. We can introduce a method. We have several cars in which different domain of engines are like, sporty. We can change the dimension of engine to the normal to sporty. You know, we have this much of facility as well within the car. So we can define the real world objects through its property methods within a JavaScript. Okay, so how you do that? We do that by defining a property and methods. And every property has a values. In, you know, from this example, we came across that every property has the values. Or car has the same methods, but the methods are performed at a different times. Now see, JavaScript objects. You have already learned that the JavaScript variables are containers from the data values. Okay, JavaScript variables are containers for the data values. Variables, what variables do? They are a container for the data values, and data types have been defined, whether number or string or, you know, array or object. These are the different definition of the data types, of the data values, to, you know, in which the variable has been, where variable variable has contained. Now see, this code, simple value phi n to the variable car name. See here, again, we just create a script. Within a script, we defined a variable car name phi n and we just put it. And the string, we just defined a variable car, and that string has been defined. In that string, we take a equal to of the, we define as a variable as a string phi n, and finally this has been introduced. So this car thing has been introduced. So finally the phi n is there. It has got a phi n as an answer. And thus, now, so simple definition here it is. When we go, this is the simple variable creation. When we create this variable car within object, we just, so first of all, the formal notation is within a curly braces. It's like function only. And to define the border, to define a function, we need a curly braces. We do define an object in a variable, we need a curly braces. Now, in the curly braces, we just type, we define a property here, property method, property value. What we need a property value methods now. So this is the property type, what is value is PN. Property model value is 500. Property color value is white. And finally the car type is the type is, and we just call type within a car, and from this is a string, and we concatenate a car object with its type only its type. Car dot type. Okay, so this is car, and we just concatenate a type, and we got a field, and we just, and we, if we concatenate like model.